right, new guitar day. New guitar day. So I posted an update about a month and a half ago about the work we've been doing with LittleCrow Guitars and them supporting American Jet Set. You can see we're all very excited in new guitar day. Kona agrees that new guitar day is the best day. Right, Kona Fish? So she's going to be very helpful. But this inside this box is the second in existence LittleCrow Blackbird. Dave and Viv at LittleCrow made it for to my specs, and I'm going to be using it in Jet Set on the new record and on our tour next year, and it should be pretty cool. So I haven't seen it yet, so let's check it out. That is sweet. Wow. Want the camera get a look at this thing?
That is beautiful.
So this is basically a T-style body with this really cool body carve here and a little contour carve on the back. Three on the side headstock with locking tuners. The LittleCrow logo there. And I think this is Souk or Sheok. I don't know how to pronounce it. Western Australia tone wood. I believe this neck is mountain ash. I will confirm that. And I think the body is mountain ash as well. Let's see what else. This is a four-way switch. I know that. And then just a standard volume and tone. And I believe there is a treble bleed in here too, which is cool. So wow, that is really cool. Look at the back here. Try to get it in the light. Kona seems impressed.
The camera girl is impressed.
The camera girl is impressed. Most important, Dave and Viv. The camera girl is impressed. So yeah, this is cool. Let me see if I can figure out how to put this trim piece in here. It looks like it's a snap-in. Yeah, pretty much. And then we'll figure it out. I think it just slides in there like that. And voila, let's tune it real quick. Pretty close. Action feels good. Looks like the setup's just about perfect. Pretty cool axe. So that's the unboxing of the LittleCrow Blackbird. So I'll be doing, I'll play it tonight, I'll record it, we'll put that on the video, and I'll get some close-up footage of it, but thank you once again, Dave and Viv and LittleCrow Guitars. This will go into the studio with us next week to start recording our new record, and this guitar will very likely be on it. So we'll get some footage of that, and super impressed. This thing looks great and feels really good. Neck feels nice and chunky, action feels good. There's a nice sustain to it. Awesome. Awesome. Well, let me do some playing on this, record it, and we'll do some tech demos on it later. Thank you. Monsters. So I've been playing the thing, this LittleCrow Blackbird, for about an hour or so, messing around with it, messing with the specs, looking at the tremolo, figuring out what I liked, what I didn't like, and I will tell you, the verdict out the gate is, wow, what a beast this thing is. Turn the volume down here. Just a fantastic instrument. Look at that. I mean, oh my gosh. But out the gate, let me give you a 5-minute sort of rundown on what I've figured out. One, out of the box, the intonation across the entire neck was perfect. I didn't have to change anything on it. It was spot on at 12, it was spot on at 5, and spot on at 3. So intonation out the gate from LittleCrow guitars, man, they just make a fantastically, solidly built instrument. Let's see the pickups. So this is a DiMarzio Chopper T. It is a railed humbucker. It's Tele-esque, but not at all. That's best I can tell you. It's great. This is something I've tried with them new. This is a PG-13, the Paul Gilbert custom mini humbucker in the neck. Now, in the Corvino, what they have is a Brierly, which is a boutique pickup out of Australia. And it's amazing. It's a cool cross between a humbucker and a Tele pickup. Sounds great. Does great for jazz. This is similar, but it's a little fatter, and frankly, I'd love this pickup. I was kind of skeptical, and I really like a Tele pickup in the neck position. Man, this thing sounds awesome, and it screams. The only thing I did with both pickups is I lowered them one full turn on the set screws. So they were a little close to the strings. I kept bumping. If I played hard, I kept bumping on the neck pickup on the strings. And they were a little too hot. So I backed them off a little bit, and now they're perfect. Controls, just got a standard tone knob. It's not a no-load tone. I may swap a no-load tone into it just to see what it sounds like. But I have nothing's jumping out to me, so I probably won't. Volume is nice. It has, I believe, a treble bleed in it. So it doesn't get muddy. You know, as you turn down, which is nice. This is also a unique four-way. So this is, I think, four-way switching on a Tele is just a must. That guy right there. So back here, it's in the bridge position. And normally on a four-way switch, you get this weird setup where you go bridge, neck, bridge in parallel, neck, which is position 3, and you got all the way here, position 4, and that gives you back into a bridge neck in series. Dave has figured out a way to put both of the middle positions in the middle. Oh,
crazy. DiMarzio said they didn't know how to do that. DiMarzio, take a lesson from LittleCrow. They figured this crap out. So that's cool, man. You go bridge in parallel, bridge in series, gives you a fatter, sort of bigger, rocky solo tone, sort of like a Les Paul on the neck. And then you get the neck all by itself right there. Perfect. The only thing I will say, the only criticism I have thus far, is between 3 and 4, you get a noticeable dead spot in the switch. How he's wired it. I'll take a look at it. I'll pull it out and look at the wiring and offer some feedback. But between 3 and 4, in the middle position, the guitar's dead. And I freaked out because I hit it there by accident. But you know, that's easy to overcome. You just got to switch aggressively. The only other thing I didn't like, I changed, is this guy right there. So this was what came with the guitar, is the big, I don't know if they're vintage, whatever, they're like a big square switcher. They sit up about this high. Man, I just do not like those. I have a bunch of these standard round knobs, and I just swap that sucker out. It's obvious Dave is using American standard equipment because the size of this post fits an American standard knob button thingy majigger. The tuners are locking tuners. They're great. Thumb screw on the back is my favorite. The black hardware is just dope. Yeah, oh, so the only other thing to talk about is, the big thing to talk about is this Trem King guy. So I'll do an in-depth sort of jam on what this thing does, but it's essentially a floating tremolo that's not locked. Crazy. But it doesn't float because this whole bridge is fixed. So the intonation point on these strings never changes. They never change position. All the action happens in the back, and it's got this cool little pop cavity. I won't pop it off now, but there's no screws. It just pops right out. It's cool. There's two springs back there. Out the gate, I will tell you, I had a tough time keeping it in tune. What I figured out, one thing is like any other guitar, the strings aren't stretched out, and this guitar is really stable going down. So you tune it. This Trem King, I figured out to tune it, you tune it going down and coming back to the note, and then you tune the strings. So you put a little, you the best I can explain it is, you actuate the tremolo, then you tune. When you see the landing point in the tremolo, and you do that a couple times, and you get it in, and it stays in. It's crazy. Any other guitar like Floyd Rose is the same thing. You lock it on both ends, and you got to fine tune it, and the strings stretch out, and you got to tune it again. But there's no locking mechanism here, so it's pretty simple, and you can untune one string and it doesn't untune the rest, which is mind-blowing. All the other strings stay in perfect tune regardless of what's going on with the bridge. It's crazy. What it doesn't do well so far, maybe I just haven't figured it out, is go up. So if you're gonna pull like a Steve Vai type jam, it goes sharp, so it doesn't land correctly. So that could be the nut wearing in. It could be I don't have the tension quite right. It could be I'm just manhandling the thing. It feels really smooth and even, but it also feels like you need a little finesse on it. All in all, Dave and Viv, LittleCrow Guitars, man, what a beast. This is just a great axe, and it's gonna get a lot of use on the road and in the studio starting next week. With American Jet Set and my solo stuff and recording and playing live, and I'm sure I'll put some dings in it on the road, and I'm sorry about that in advance. But man, I couldn't be more humbled for the work that they did and delivered this to me, and it's just awesome. So over the next couple weeks, I'll be doing an in-depth on the pickups, on the back of the Trem King and all the wiring, and sort of give you an in-depth view of how LittleCrow builds their guitars. Dave sent me a lot of build photos, and we'll kind of just go into a tech rundown of the guitar. And then I'll do a couple playthroughs on some Jet Set songs. We'll get some footage of it in the studio, and it'll be pretty cool, man. So, LittleCrow Guitars at littlecrow.com, Dave and Viv. Check them out. They make a mean axe, and they're super easy to work with and get whatever you need out of them. Appreciate it, and see you later, monsters.